Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to Bankers Adda. Today is day 8, reasoning quiz for IBPS exam 2019. Directions 1 to 2. Monte, who is facing north, starts from point A and walks 4 meter towards the right. Agar Monte yahan hai, jo ki north dekh raha hai, to uska right hoga is direction mein. राइट डायरेक्शन में वो 4 मीटर वॉक करता है. ही देन टेक्स अ लेफ्ट टर्न एंड वॉक्स 3 मीटर. लेफ्ट टर्न एंड वॉक्स 3 मीटर बिफोर टेकिंग अ राइट टर्न एंड वॉकिंग 2 मीटर एंड स्टॉपिंग एट पॉइंट बी. अगेन राइट टर्न है जिसमें वो 2 मीटर वॉक करता है एंड बी पॉइंट पे स्टॉप करता है. दिशा स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम द सेम पॉइंट ए, वॉक्स 2 मीटर टूवर्ड्स साउथ. She then takes a left turn and walks 4 meter. She now takes a right turn and walks 2 meter. And then takes a left turn and walks for 2 meter. So clearly yahan hoga. And stops at point C. And B and C jo hai, same line mein honge. So chalte hain questions ki taraf. Question number 1, what is the distance between point B and C? So clearly 3 plus 2 and plus 2, that is 7 meter. This option C is our correct answer. Question number 2, if Disha walks 4 meter towards north from point C, how far will she be from point A? Agar Disha 4 meter jati hai, to clearly Disha yahan hogi. How far is she from point A? Clearly 4 meter. Aur ye jo 2 meters usne walk kiya tha. Clearly 6 meters hoga. Isliye option C hamara correct answer hai. Directions 3 to 5. Study the information and answer the following questions. P starts from point C towards west and walks 2 kilometers. So, agar point C se walk karti hai towards west or 2 kilometer walk karti hai. From there, he turns to his left and walks 2 kilometers. Again, 2 kilometers. He then turns to his right and walks 5 kilometers and stops at point D. तो अगर राइट होगा तो 5 kilometers एंड स्टॉप्स एट पॉइंट डी. हिज फ्रेंड क्यू स्टार्ट्स वॉकिंग इन साउथ डायरेक्शन. फॉर 4 kilometers. सो फ्रॉम पॉइंट डी है 4 kilometers साउथ में. ही देन टर्न्स टू हिज लेफ्ट एंड वॉक्स 7 kilometers. तो 5 and 2 तो क्लियरली यहां पे होगा सी. ही देन टेक्स अ लेफ्ट टर्न अगेन एंड वॉक्स फॉर 4 kilometers. तो क्लियरली यहां होगा टू रीच पॉइंट ई. तो ये होगा पॉइंट ई. क्वेश्चन नंबर 3, हाउ फार इज पी फ्रॉम क्यू. पी यहां पे है. P का इनिशियल पॉइंट ये है और फाइनल पॉइंट यहां है. Q का फाइनल पॉइंट यहां है. सॉरी, इनिशियल पॉइंट यहां है और फाइनल पॉइंट यहां है. सो हाउ फार इज P फ्रॉम Q? क्लियरली 7 kilometers का डिस्टेंस है. इसलिए ऑप्शन E हमारा करेक्ट आंसर है. Question number 4. How far and in which direction is point E from C? E from C clearly ये 2 किलोमीटर का डिस्टेंस है एंड साउथ में है, इसलिए ऑप्शन ए हमारा करेक्ट आंसर है. क्वेश्चन नंबर 5, इन विच डायरेक्शन इज क्यूज इनिशियल पॉइंट दैट इज डी फ्रॉम पीज इनिशियल पॉइंट दैट इज सी. तो डी सी के साउथ वेस्ट में है, इसलिए ऑप्शन ई हमारा करेक्ट आंसर है. क्वेश्चन नंबर 6, राम वॉक्ड 40 मीटर्स टुवर्ड्स वेस्ट एंड टुक अ लेफ्ट टर्न एंड वॉक्ड 30 मीटर्स. तो 30 मीटर्स होगा यहाँ. ही देन टुक अ राइट टर्न एंड वॉक्ड फॉर 20 मीटर्स. अगेन ही टुक अ राइट टर्न एंड वॉक्ड फॉर 30 मीटर्स. तो क्लियरली यहाँ होगा इनिशियल पॉइंट, यहाँ एंड फाइनल पॉइंट यहाँ. जो डायरेक्शन होगी वो इस तरह होगी. हाउ फार इज ही फ्रॉम हिज स्टार्टिंग पॉइंट, क्लियरली 20 प्लस 40, तो क्लियरली 60 मीटर्स है, इसलिए ऑप्शन बी हमारा करेक्ट आंसर है. डायरेक्शन 7 to 8, ये कोडेड डायरेक्शन का क्वेश्चन है. क्वेश्चन नंबर 7, एम इज वेस्ट ऑफ एन, तो एम यहां होगा तो एन यहां होगा. एन इज नॉर्थ ऑफ ओ एंड ओ इज साउथ ऑफ पी. तो क्लियरली पी यहां भी हो सकता है, पी यहां भी कहीं हो सकता है, पी यहां भी कहीं हो सकता है. पी का कोई डेफिनेट हमारा पोजीशन नहीं है. इन विच डायरेक्शन इज ओ फ्रॉम एम, क्लियरली साउथ ईस्ट डायरेक्शन में है, तो इसलिए ऑप्शन ई हमारा करेक्ट आंसर है. क्वेश्चन नंबर 8, जी इज ईस्ट ऑफ टी T is north of Q and Q is west of M. तो M यहां भी हो सकता है, यहां भी हो सकता है और यहां भी आगे भी हो सकता है. तो M की पोजीशन यहां भी हो सकती है, यहां भी हो सकती है, यहां भी हो सकती है. In which direction is M from G? तो clearly इस direction में होगा तो अलग डायरेक्शन होगी, यहां होगा तो अलग डायरेक्शन होगी और यहां होगा तो अलग डायरेक्शन होगी, इसलिए ऑप्शन ई हमारा करेक्ट आंसर है. क्वेश्चन नंबर 9, पी लीव्स हिज होम एंड गो स्ट्रेट 20 मीटर्स देन टर्न्स टू हिज राइट. तो गो स्ट्रेट 20 मीटर्स देन टर्न्स टू हिज राइट एंड वॉक्स फॉर 10 मीटर्स. ही देन टर्न्स टू हिज लेफ्ट एंड गोस 30 मीटर्स and finally turns right and starts walking. Now if he is moving in the north direction, then in which direction did he start his walking? Clearly हाँ हम देख सकते हैं, जब south direction में अगर वो finally walk कर रहा है तो initially वो east direction में walk कर रहा था, और अगर हमारे question में दिया गया है कि वो north direction में move कर रहा है तो यही डायग्राम उल्टा हो जाएगा और वो वेस्ट डायरेक्शन में मूव कर रहा होगा इनिशियली, इसलिए ऑप्शन बी हमारा करेक्ट आंसर है. क्वेश्चन नंबर 10, विलेज बी इज सिचुएटेड टू द नॉर्थ ऑफ विलेज ए. तो ए अगर यहां होगा देन बी यहां होगा. विलेज सी इज सिचुएटेड टू द ईस्ट ऑफ बी, तो सी यहां कहीं होगा. विलेज डी इज सिचुएटेड टू द वेस्ट ऑफ ए, तो डी यहां कहीं होगा. इन विच डायरेक्शन इज विलेज डी सिचुएटेड विद रिस्पेक्ट टू विलेज सी, क्लियरली साउथ वेस्ट डायरेक्शन में होगा, इसलिए ऑप्शन ई हमारा करेक्ट आंसर है. नंबर 11, फ्रॉम हिज होम ए वेंट 15 किलोमीटर्स टू द नॉर्थ, 15 किलोमीटर्स टू द नॉर्थ, ही देन टर्न्स वेस्ट एंड कवर 20 किलोमीटर्स, ही देन टर्न्ड साउथ एंड कवर्ड 5 किलोमीटर्स, एंड फाइनली टर्निंग टू ईस्ट ही कवर्ड 25 किलोमीटर्स. ये जो डिस्टेंस हो जाएगा वो होगा 5 किलोमीटर्स. इन विच डायरेक्शन इज ही फ्रॉम हिज होम? होम अगर यहां था और फाइनल पोजिशन यहां है तो क्लियरली नॉर्थ ईस्ट डायरेक्शन में है, इसलिए ऑप्शन बी हमारा करेक्ट आंसर है. क्वेश्चन नंबर 12, पी स्टार्ट्स हिज जर्नी फ्रॉम हिज होम एंड ही वॉक्स 10 किलोमीटर्स टुवर्ड्स साउथ डायरेक्शन, 10 किलोमीटर्स towards south direction. He takes a left turn and walks 8 kilometers. After that, he takes a right turn and walks for 10 kilometers. Now he walks 14 kilometers after turning towards his right. So clearly, yahan kahin hoga. And 14 kilometers. Finally, he reached his office. So clearly, home hoga yahan aur office hai yahan. In which direction is P's office with respect to P's home? So clearly, southwest direction mein hai. Isliye option A hamara correct answer hai. Question number 13. Ria started walking 2 kilometers in south direction. Then takes 3 consecutive left turns and walked distances 3, 4 and 5 kilometers respectively. So, pehle turn pe 3 kilometers, then next turn pe 4 kilometers and then next left turn pe 5 kilometers. Now, in which direction is Ria's final point with respect to her initial point? So, initial point hai yahan. And final point hai yahan. So, clearly, northwest direction mein hai. Isliye option A hamara correct answer hai. Directions 14 to 15. P starts from point Y and moves towards east direction for 5 kilometers. Agar Y yaha hai, then east direction mein usne 5 kilometers walk kiya hai. Then takes a right turn and walks for 4 kilometers. He then takes a left turn and walks for 6 kilometers. Finally, he takes a right turn and walks 7 kilometers to reach point G. Ye hai point G. Now, Q starts from point X and walks for 9 kilometers towards her west and reaches point G. So clearly, X कहीं यहां होगा. और ये 9 किलोमीटर का डिस्टेंस होगा. Now, in which direction is point X with respect to Y? Clearly, southeast direction है. इसलिए option D हमारा correct answer है. Question number 15. If point Z is 2 kilometers to the southwest of the second turning point of P, first turning point है ये और second turning point है ये. तो अगर यहाँ से southwest में 2 kilometers है, तो कहीं यहाँ कहीं होगा. Then in which direction is point Z with respect to point G? यहाँ होगा Z. With respect to G, तो clearly northwest है, इसलिए option C हमारा correct answer है.
Hello students and welcome to bankersadda.com. So the IBPS calendar for 2019 has been released and we are conducting a 6-month preparation plan for the same. Those who want to get selected this year should start their practice from now on to achieve this milestone in their lives. So today is the day 8 for the series and the topic for today's quiz is column based. These questions were seen throughout the year 2018 in most of the exams, and many questions of this type were mostly in preliminary examinations, and it is very important because agar aap pre clear karenge tabhi aap mains mein ja payenge. So let's start. Question kya hai? Column 1 hai, column 2 hai. Sentences या phrases जो भी आप कह लें उनको आपको join करना है और जो correct sentence बनाएगा वो आपका answer होगा. देखते हैं. A budget is an estimate of outflows and inflows that इसमें देखेंगे तो आप a government will incur during a financial year. AE AE बन रहा है. अब आप देखिए तो AE इसमें है, इसमें इसमें है. AF नहीं बन रहा है, eliminate हो गया. Under article 112 of the constitution a statement of receipts and payment kept aside of unforeseen expenses नहीं आ रहा इसके साथ ये has to be tabled in the parliament for every financial year. Yes, BF is going. तो AE और BF किस में दिया है? Simple है, इसी में दिया है. ये दोनों eliminate हो गए. अब none of these भी हो सकता है अगर इसमें C के साथ बन जाए D का, और ऐसी कोई choice नहीं है तो none of these लगाएंगे. The contingency fund is a corpus of about rupees 50 crore kept aside of unforeseen expenses. अगर आप देखें यहाँ for होता तो ये सेंटेंस ग्रामेटिकली बनता, अभी नहीं बन रहा है. तो आपका जो आंसर होगा वो होगा ए ई एन बी एफ. इन क्वेश्चंस को आप एलिमिनेशन मेथड से बेस्ट सॉल्व कर सकते हैं. ओके तो स्टूडेंट्स, इंग्लिश जो है आप जानते हैं बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक है, बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट सब्जेक्ट है आपके बैंकिंग एग्जामिनेशंस का. तो अगर आपको इस टॉपिक में दिक्कत है, इस सब्जेक्ट में दिक्कत है, तो आपके लिए ये टॉपिक वाइज टेस्ट सीरीज है सिर्फ इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज के लिए. वीडियो सॉल्यूशंस मिलेंगे और टोटल कम से कम 600 प्लस क्वेश्चंस यू विल गेट इन दिस टेस्ट सीरीज. सो टू एक्सेल इन अ सब्जेक्ट द बेस्ट थिंग इज टू प्रैक्टिस दैट सब्जेक्टिव क्वेश्चंस रेगुलरली. तो यू कैन अवेल दिस टेस्ट सीरीज एंड स्टार्ट योर प्रैक्टिसेस. क्वेश्चन टू देखते हैं. इफ यू सी वन ऑफ द एसेंशियल बिजनेस सपोर्टिंग एलिमेंट इज अ मैकेनिज्म to settle failed or bankrupt entities without is unable नहीं होगा, to collectively can resolve नहीं, without causing damage to any players in the economy पूरा related है. Next देखते हैं. In every economy there should be a legal procedure accompanied by institutions to collectively can resolve. इसमें institutions की बात आ रहा है पर grammatically ठीक नहीं है. Bankruptcy is a final condition where a firm individual is unable to repay debts to creditors. तो A और C D आपका यहाँ पर हो जाएगा. तो आपका ये ऑप्शन किस में है? ये B में है. ठीक है, तो ये B आपका ठीक हो जाएगा. ऑप्शन B विल बी करेक्ट हियर. क्वेश्चन थ्री देखते हैं. अ स्टार्क इंक्रीज इन पॉपुलेशन ग्रोथ अलोंग विद राइजिंग लाइफ एक्सपेक्टेंसी प्रोवाइड्स द बर्डन ऑफ क्रोनिक डिजीजेस. तो आपका एएफ बन रहा है. ये दोनों एलिमिनेट. इन्वेस्टमेंट्स इन हेल्थ एंड सोशल सर्विसेज टेंड टू टेक प्रेसिडेंस ओवर पब्लिक हेल्थ एक्सपेंडिचर. इफ यू सी BDB बन रहा है. हेल्थ कम्युनिकेशन एंड इंटीग्रल आर्म ऑफ पब्लिक हेल्थ एम्स टू डिसेमिनेट क्रिटिकल इन्फॉर्मेशन टू इम्प्रूव द हेल्थ लिटरेसी ऑफ द पीपल. CEB बन रहा है. आपको सारे सेंटेंसेस कंबाइन करके देखने होंगे. तो आपका ए ऑप्शन है. आप हिट एंड ट्रायल मेथड से भी इसको कर सकते हैं. देखते जाइए कौन कौन सा है, अगर वो ज्वाइन हो रहा है तो उसे टिक कर सकते हैं. लेट्स सी क्वेश्चन नंबर 4. इफ यू सी AF दिया जैसे, तो द वर्ल्ड हेल्थ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन कॉल्स फॉर एफर्ट्स टू इम्प्रूव हेल्थ लिटरेसी एंड इंडिपेंडेंट डिटर्मिनेंट ऑफ बेटर हेल्थ आउटकम. एफर्ट्स की बात हो रही है और डिटर्मिनेंट कोई रिलेशन नहीं है, तो AF ही नहीं बन रहा तो पूरा ही गलत हो गया. AE देखते हैं. द वर्ल्ड हेल्थ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन कॉल्स फॉर एफर्ट्स टू इम्प्रूव हेल्थ लिटरेसी. इट इज द रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ऑफ पब्लिक हेल्थ प्रोफेशनल्स टू क्लोज द गैप. किसी गैप की अभी यहाँ पर बात नहीं है, तो ये भी गया, यानी ए ये भी नहीं है, तो CE बच रहा है. इंडिया सर्टेनली हैज अ सीरियस प्रॉब्लम विद हेल्थ एंड लिटरेसी एंड इट इज द रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ऑफ पब्लिक हेल्थ प्रोफेशनल्स टू क्लोज द गैप. यस. Now look at this. Data from the US show that close to half of Americans lack the necessary knowledge to act. Action ki yahan koi baat nahi hai. To aapka answer ho jayega option D. Next. Question 5. In the summer of 2018, while posted in the glamorous city of Gorakhpur, I decided to take a day off and visit Nepal. AF. Enticed by the promise of serenity, he did not even follow was immense. Nahi ban raha. And teased by the promise of serenity, I booked a cab without a second thought. To ye bhi ban raha hai yahan par. His understanding of a religion. His understanding of a religion that he did not even follow was immense. ठीक है, तो आपका आंसर बन गया ए. तीनों के तीनों मैच हो रहे हैं. Okay, so students, mission SBI PO 2019. As you know, SBI PO का notification भी expected है. So उसके लिए भी आपको preparation आज से ही start करनी चाहिए. ये test series में आपको 40 plus total test मिलेंगे, 20 puzzle के, DI के और logical reasoning के. ठीक है, ये तीनों topic आपके लिए बहुत important है. So start your preparations. Now question 6. In electronics, a transistor is a semiconductor device commonly have be lower nahi hoga. Commonly used to amplify or switch electronic signals. So AE. AE aa gaya, ye dono to gaye. Uske baad, agrarian distress is in the present context is mainly in terms of low agricultural supplies and consequently poor farm incomes. BF is also correct. CD dekhte hain. Market prices for several agricultural commodities have been lower than those of minimum support price. So those of yahan par incorrectly use hua that of hona chahiye. To CD to nahi ban raha hai. To aapka answer kaun sa ho jayega? Option C. Question 7. When output increases well beyond the market demand at a price remunerative to producers, market prices decline. A is absolutely correct. AF देखते हैं. बियॉन्ड प्राइस डिक्रीज बिलो अ सर्टेन स्पेसिफाइड लेवल, कोई सेंस नहीं बन रहा है, नहीं बनेगा ये हो सकता है. AE वाला BF देखते हैं. इन द एब्सेंस ऑफ एन इफेक्टिव प्राइस सपोर्ट पॉलिसी फार्मर्स आर फेस्ड बियॉन्ड प्राइस डिक्रीज, ये भी नहीं है. CD देखते हैं. अ प्राइस डेफिशिएंसी स्कीम में कॉम्पेंसेट फार्मर्स विद अ लॉस इन इनकम डिपेंड ऑन हाउ मच द प्राइस डिक्लाइन इज. डिपेंड ऑन नहीं होगा, डिपेंड्स ऑन, ये भी नहीं है. तो आपका आंसर हो जाएगा ऑप्शन बी. Next, government policies have been biased. A lack of opportunities have been biased. Cereals particularly replacing agriculture agricultural subsidies by capital formation or investment nahi hai. Many small farmers cannot leave agriculture because ke aage koi reason nahi aa raha hai. Because of a lack hota to sahi hota, because a lack of opportunities bhi nahi hai. A reconfiguration of public policy is needed. Kya? Needed to hona chahiye, kuch aisa koi sentence yahan nahi hai. To aapka yahan par koi bhi choice nahi ban rahi hai. Next, for 3.5 decades now, subsidies have progressively replaced public investment over agriculture. Agar aap F wala dekhein, F, to ye correct ja raha hai. Next, in 2012, then Prime Minister Manmohan Singh declared that the unacceptably high level of more than a third of Indian children are stunted or underweight. If you see, BE to nahi ban raha hai, BD, level of child malnutrition in the country is a matter of national shame. BD bhi theek hai. See, dekhte hain, several years down the line, sample surveys indicate that more than a third of ye survey ki baat aa rahi hai, ye bhi theek hai. To aapka answer ho jayega option A. Moving towards the next question, the blank launched an advertising campaign to aana chahiye, to lure back its traditional customers. Bilkul theek hai. Next, dekhte hain, government inspections ensure a high degree of uniformity in the standard service. Yeah. To lure shoppers, some merchants have employees, some employed hone chahiye. Theek hai? To ye nahi ban raha. Ye bhi kya? Answer ho jayega C. Question 11. Changes in design will ensure the quality and reliability of the printer. If you see, A hi aapka ban raha hai. Next, dekhte hain, we must make a real effort to ensure greater coordination between the different groups. BF ban raha hai. We need to ensure a smooth transition, the old system and the new one. Kuch missing hai. So, nahi hoga. So, A and BF, that means C is the correct choice. Question 12. Dekhte hain, commercial exploitation of resources threatens our survival. Bilkul theek hai. The survival rate for people who have this form of cancer is now more than 90%. Theek hai? The arrival of this South American predator threatened the survival of native species. Ye bhi theek hai. So, aapka pehla option hi yahan par correct ho jayega. Option A. Question 13. The joint venture ended in a legal wrangle between the two companies. If you see, A hi aapka ban raha hai, F nahi ban raha hai. The directors of the company refused to undertake such a risky venture. BF. This is eliminated. Continued trade in these products is threat to the survival. This is wrong. So A and BF is correct. Question number 14. They're doing tests to evaluate the effectiveness of this herb. Simple. Eh? The next stage is an important one in your ability to evaluate, assess and improve your own work. So, agar aap dekhe, the next stage is an important one in your ability to evaluate, assess and improvement of your work. So, isme bhi error hai. Dekhne mein aapko ye lag sakta hai correct, par ye grammatically correct nahi hai. It can be difficult to evaluate the effectiveness of different treatments. So, CF. That means option D is the choice. Last question for the day. If you see AF, I am pleased to report that the various committees are now working in unison to thoroughly investigate this matter. Theek hai? BD, the exam went quite well except at the end when I tripped up on the final question. Theek hai? CE dekh lete hain ek bari. Ye ho sakta hai, ye bhi ho sakta hai, ye dono nahi ho sakte. AF, BD or CE, you should allocate the same amount of time to each question. This is also correct. That means option D will be your correct choice. Okay, that's all for today's session. Thank you and have a nice day.
Good morning, friends. Today we are going to discuss quantitative aptitude quiz based on ratio and proportion for IBPS. Okay, pure clerk, and the date is 31st January 2019. Okay, so today is last day of January 2019, and today is day 8. Okay, and the title of the IBPS for IBPS quant is Kar IBPS 2019 Fateh. Okay, now we will see the topics. Here topic is percentage, so the question will be based on percentage. Now we will move on questions. In the first question, Raghav bought two mobiles in a total of rupees 19,200. He sold first mobile at a profit of 60% and the second mobile at a loss of 20%. In the whole transaction, he got a net profit of 25%. Find the cost price of each mobile. So here, let cost price of first mobile. Here there will be two methods to solve this question. So we will see the first basic method, cost price of first mobile x, then cost price of second mobile will be 19,200 minus x. Okay, so here total selling price first mobile at 60% profit 160x upon 100 plus second mobile at a loss of 20%, so 80 upon 100 19,200 minus x. Okay, now net profit of 25%, so according to question, total selling price minus total cost price, this is total selling price 160x upon 100 plus 80 upon 100 19,200 minus x, this is minus cost price, total cost price is 19,200, and this is equal to 25% of cost price, that is net profit 19,200. Okay, from here if we solve this, this will be 16x or 16x plus this will be 8 19,200 minus x minus 19,200 is equal to this is 25 into 19,200. Okay, from here if we solve this, this is 16x minus 8x plus this will be 15,153,600, and this is 25 into 19,200, this will be 25 into 19,200 will be 19,200 upon into 25, this is 0 0, 19 into 5 95 and 297, sorry 96, because one is remainder here 0 4, and 19 into 2 38, so this is 38 0 0 0 9 8 17 1 18 3 1 4, so this is 48,000 plus 19,200. If we add this, this will be equal to 24,000, 4 times 0. Okay, so here if we solve this, 8x will be equal to 244 times 0 minus 153,600, this will be equal to 86,400, so value of x will be 108,000. 0. This is the cost price of first mobile, so cost price of second mobile will be second mobile total 19200 minus 10800, that is 8400. So these are the cost price of two mobiles, and if you look at options, A will be the right option. Okay, this is the basic method. Now this question can also be solved by mixture and allegation. Okay, so first profit is 60%, so first mobile, this is second, profit 60%, and here loss of 20%, so here we will take minus sign 20%, and here total net profit is 25%, so this is plus. Okay, so here this will be 35, and this is 25 minus 20, this will be 45. Okay, so the cost price of first mobile, so here this is the first is to second, this will be 45 is to 35, that is 9 is to 7. Okay, so from here we can find the cost price of first mobile. So first will be 9 by 16 into 19200, from here this will be 1 and this is 200, so 12 into 9, this will be 10800, and second will be 19200 minus 10800, this is 8400. So this is the simplest method according to mixture and allegation. So in exam we will proceed on, we will solve such type of question according to mixture and allegation. So this is the simplest method, or we can say short trick for this question. Okay, so here this is the simplest solution of this question. Okay, now we'll move on question number second. In the second question, the present population of a village is 40,000. The population increases in next year at a rate of 20%, but in further next year the population decreases by a certain rate. If after 2 years the population is 33600, then find the rate of decrement of population in the second year. So here this is present population. In first year increment is 20%, so 120 upon 100, and in second let decrement was x percent, so 100 minus x upon, we can say here let x percent, in second year of population was remain x percent, so x upon 100, and this is equal to 33600. So from here value of x will be 33600 upon 120 into 4. Okay, because 2020 cancelled. So from here this is 00 cancelled, and this is 840. Okay, so 840 upon 12, this will be 70. Okay, so the required decrement rate will be, required decrement rate will be in second year 100 minus 70, that is 30%. Okay, so if you look at options, D will be the right option. Okay, next question, question number third. In the third question, the height of a hollow cone is 66 into 2 by 3% more than that of a side of a square whose perimeter is 72 meters. The diameter of base of cone is 80 meters. If cost of painting of outer surface of cone is 7 rupees per meter square, then find the total cost to paint the outer surface of the cone. Okay, so there such like a, this is a cone. Okay, and this is the outer surface. So we have to paint this outer surface at the rate of 7 rupees per meter square. Okay, this is the altitude and this is the radius of base. Now height is 66 into 2/3%, so 66 into 2/3% can be written as directly 2/3. Okay, and the perimeter of square is 72 meters, so side of square will be, or we can say height of cone will be 1 plus 2/3 of 72/4, because this is the side of square. So here this will be 5/3 into 18, so this is 30 meters. So this is h, so h is 30 meter, and diameter of base is 80 meters. So this is r will be, this is r will be 80/2, that is 40 meters. So slant height of cone will be, slant height of cone, this is slant height. Okay, this will be h square plus r square, so h is 30 square plus r is 40 square. Here this will be 50 meters. Now surface area of cone will be pi r l. Okay, this is the formula of surface area of cone. This is value of pi, 22/7, r is 40, and this is 30, l is 50. Okay, so total cost surface area into rate of painting. So surface area is 22/7, and this is 40 into 50, this is 2000, and cost is 7 rupees per meter square. So into 7 cancel, 22 into 2 44, or 3 times 0. Okay, so this is the total cost to paint the outer surface of the cone, 44000. That is, option C will be the right option. Okay friends, now we will move on next question, the question number 4th. A dishonest retailer cheats his wholesaler and customer both. He purchases 19% more from the wholesaler and sells 15% less while selling to its customer. What is the profit percentage by selling the goods at cost price? Okay, so here direct we can find selling price for retailer selling price for retailer will be 119, 19% more, so 119. If original quantity is 100, then for retailer this will be 119, and selling price for retailer will be 15% less sell karta hai, so it means 100/85. Okay, this is the total selling price for retailer, and cost price is 100. Okay, original cost price of quantity, this is 100, so the required percentage profit will be, or we can say profit to the retailer will be 119 into 100/85 minus 100, this is 140 and this is 100, that is 40%. This is the required profit percentage to the retailer. Okay, so if you look at option, C will be the right option. Okay, next question, question number fifth. In the fifth question, in a class, the number of boys and the number of girls are in the ratio of 2:3. If the number of boys is increased by 20% and the number of girls is increased by 20, then the new ratio of the number of boys to that of girls is 3:5. What is the total strength of the increase? So let initial boys 2x and that of girls 3x. Okay. Number of boys increase 20% and girls increase by 20. So new ratio according to question 2x into 120 upon 100. This is the new number of boys and the new number of girls will be 3x plus 20 and the new ratio is 3:5. From here this will be 6 by 5, so this is 12x upon 5 divided by 3x plus 20 and this is equal to 3 by 5. From here this will be 12x and this is 9x plus 6 0. Okay, so here x will be 60 upon 3, that is 20. So total strength after increase, total strength after increase will be total number of boys is 12x upon 5, so 12 into 20 upon 5 plus total number of girls 3x, so 3 into 20 plus 20, so this is 48 and this is 80. So total will be 128. This is the total number of strength of class after increase. So if you look at options, C will be the right option. Okay, next question, question was sixth. In the sixth question, in a class of 80 students and 5 teachers, each student got sweets that are 15% of the total number of students and each teacher got sweets that are 25% of the total number of students. How many sweets were there? Okay, so let total sweets, or we can say here total sweets directly, total sweets will be eight zero. This is the total number of students and each student got 15% of the total number of students, so 15 upon 100 into 80. This is the number of sweets obtained by one student. Okay, and 5 teachers, so 5 into each teacher got 25% of total number of students, that is 25 upon 100 into 80. So from here this will be 15 into 8, 0 0 cancelled, 15 into 8 120 into 8 plus this is 4, 25 upon 100, that is 1 by 4 and this is 2 0. Okay, so this is 100, this is 1 0, 12 into 8, 9 6 0 plus 1 0 0. So this will be 1060. This is the total number of sweets. So if you look at options, D will be the right option. Okay, next question, question number 7th. In the 7th question, Greece spent rupees 38460 on the renovation of his home and rupees 24468 on buying home theater and remained with 28% of the total amount. What was the total amount? Okay, so here remained amount is 28%, so spend amount will be 100 minus 28%, so it means 100 minus 28%, this is equivalent, implies total spent amount, this is 38460 plus 2, 4, 4, 6, 8. Okay, so 100%, that is total amount. Total amount will be, this is the summation of this spent amount. This is 8, this is 6, 6, 12, 2, remainder 1, and 4, 4, 8, 1, 9, 4, 8, 12, 2, remainder 1, 3, 2, 1, 3, 2, 5, 1, 6. 6, 2, 9, 2, 8 divided by 72 into 100. Okay, if we solve this, if you solve this, or we can simplify this, this will be equal to 87400. Okay, so this is the required answer. Or we can say total amount, total amount of Girish. So if you look at options, C will be the right option. Okay, next question, question number 8. In the 8th question, the compound interest for 2 years on a certain sum is equal to the simple interest accrued on the same sum at the rate of 23% for 3 years. What is the rate of compound interest? Okay, so here simple interest for 3 years is equal to compound interest for 2 years at different rates. So simple interest will be same sum, that is P. So P, P will be cancelled. P, rate of interest for simple is, simple interest is 23% for 3 years upon 100, and this is equal to P, compound interest for 2 years, 1 plus R upon 100 square minus 1, where R is the rate of percent of compound interest. Okay, for CI. So here PP cancel, this is 69 upon 100, and this is 1 plus R upon 100 square minus 1. So from here this will be 1 plus R upon 100 square equals to 169 upon 100, or we can say 1 plus R upon 100, this will be equal to 13 upon 10. So the value of R will be, from here value of R will be 30%. Okay, so this is the required rate of percent, and if you look at options, C will be the right option. Okay, next question, question number 9th. In the 9th question, the cost price of a certain thing is 4 times the profit earned on it. A shopkeeper gives 20% discount on the mark price of that thing. If the mark price of the thing is rupees 1250, then what is the cost price of the thing? Okay, so here first the easy method will be, suppose profit is rupees X, then cost price will be 4X, because cost price is 4 times of the profit and 20% discount. So selling price will be 80 upon 100 into mark price, that is 1250. This will be 1000. Okay, so here profit will be 1000 minus 4x. This is the cost price. This will be equal to X, because X is the profit. So value of X will be 1000 upon 5, or we can say 200. Okay, so this is the profit earned on the thing. So the cost price will be, cost price 200 into 4, that is 800. Okay, 800 will be the cost price. And if you look at options, D will be the right option. Okay, next question, question number 10th. In the 10th question, a merchant marked his goods 25% more than the cost price. He sold 3/4 of goods in marked price, 1/8 at 36% discount, and the rest at 20% discount. His total profit would be, okay, so you let, Let cost price is 100, then mark price will be 25% more, that is 125. So selling price will be selling price 3/4 in mark price, so 3 by 4 into 125, 18 at 36% discount, so 1 by 8, 1 by 8 into 36% discount, that is 64 of 100 into 125 plus remaining. So remaining will be 3/4 plus 1 by 8. This will be equal to 3 plus 2 upon 8, that is 5 by 8. So the remaining will be 1 minus 5 by 8. So this is 3 by 8. 3 by 8 into 20% discount, so 80 upon 100 into 125. This is the total selling price. Now this will be 6 plus 1 upon 8 that is 7 by 8. So here this will be 1 by 8, remaining will be 1 by 8, and simply we can say 3/4 is this, so remaining is 1/4, so 1/8 is the half of 1/4, so this is 1/8, so next would be 1/8. Now the selling price will be total selling price will be, if we solve this, this will be 9375, and this will be this will be 10, because 8 and 8 into 125 will be 1000 upon 100, this is 10. Okay, so here 10, so this is 12.5. okay, if we add these all, this will be 116.25. this is the total selling price of the good. So required profit will be, required profit percentage will be 116.25 minus cost price 100, that is 16.25%. okay, so here C will be the right option. Okay, next question, question number 11th. In the 11th question, a merchant has 88 kg of sugar. A part of this he sells at 10% gain and rest at the loss of 12%. Overall he losses 3%. What is the quantity he sold at 12% loss? So this will be solved by mixture and allegation. So part at 10% gain, part at gain 10%, and part at loss is 12%. Okay, so minus will be here, and total is, overall is 3% loss, so also this is minus 3%. So according to mixture allegation, this will be 10 minus of minus 3, that is 13, and minus 3 and minus of minus 12, this will be 9. So part at gain, part and loss will be part at gain and part at loss ratio will be 9:13. So the required answer will be, or we can say part at loss will be 12% loss. This is 13 upon 22 into 88 total quantity. So 13 into 4 will be 52 kg. Okay, so the merchant sold 52 kg at a loss of 12%. Okay, now if you look at options, B will be the right option. Okay, next question, question number 12th. In the 12th question, a vessel of 70 liters is filled with milk and water. 75% milk and 25% water is taken out of the vessel. If it is found that the vessel is vacated by 60%, find the initial quantity of water. Here, let initial quantity of water is, let initial quantity of water is 1 liter. So milk will be 70 minus x liter. Okay, so here 75% milk, so 70 minus x into 75% plus what is 25%, so x into 25 upon 100, and the total container is vacated by 60%, so 60 upon 100 into 70. Okay, so from here this can be written as 3 by 4. So 3 by 4, 70 minus x, and this is x by 4. This is equal to 6 into 7 42. So this is 3 into 70. So 3 into 7 will be 210 minus 3x plus x upon 4. This is equal to 42. From here 2x will be equal to 210 minus 42 into 4. So 42 into 4 will be 4 into 2 8 and 4 into 4 1 6. So from here 2x will be equal to 210 minus 1 6 8 2 and 10 minus 6 4, that is 42. So value of x will be 21 liters. Okay, so initial quantity of water is 21 liters, and if you look at options, A will be the right option. Okay, next question, question number 13th. In the 13th question, the cost price of a TV is 72% of mark price of a fridge. The shopkeeper allows 25% discount on mark price of fridge and sells it at a profit of 20%. If cost price of the fridge is 5000 rupees, then what is the cost price of the TV? So here selling price of TV will be, we can say mark price of TV will be direct mark price of, cost price is 5000 and profit is 20%. Here mark price of fridge, because all information are given about fridge. So mark price of fridge will be cost price 5000, so 5000, and selling price will be profit is 20%, so 120 upon 100. This is the selling price of fridge, and mark price will be, here discount is 25%, so mark price will be 100 upon 75. Okay, so this is cancelled, and 5000 into 120 upon 75. Okay, so here this is 15, and 15 in 120 divided 15 will be 8, So this is 8,000. This is the mark price of fridge. So cost price of fridge will be, cost price of TV will be, which is asked in the question, 8,000 into 72%, that is 7 to 100. So here 8 into 2 16, remainder 1, 8 into 7 56, and 157, that is 5760. This is the cost price of the TV. So if you look at options, C will be the right option. Okay, next question, question number 14. In the 14th question, a pigeon gets 300 grams as daily diet, having mixture of X and Y. If X has 10% protein and Y has 15% protein, and if pigeon gets daily 38 gram protein, find the quantity of X in the mixture. So this protein in X and Y are 10% and 15%, and daily protein obtained by pigeon is 38 gram. So we will convert this into percentage. So 38 gram in percentage will be 38/300 into 100, that is 38/3%. Okay, so X, Y, in X percentage protein is 10%, in Y 15%, and totally 38/3%. So 38/3 will be greater than 10 but less than 15. So here this is 8/3, 38/3 minus 10, and this is 15 minus 38/3. So 15 minus 38/3 will be 15 to 3 45, minus 38/3. This is 15 minus 8, 7/3. So this is 7/3. So the required ratio will be, or we can say ratio of protein in X and protein in Y will be 7/8. So quantity of X, quantity of X will be, we can say here quantity of X and quantity of Y, this is quantity of X and this is quantity of Y. Okay, so quantity of X will be 7/15 into 300. So this is 2072140 gram. This is the total quantity of X in the mixture. So if you look at options, D will be the right option. Okay, next question, last question of this quiz, question number 15. In the 15th question, the ratio of speeds of a car, jeep and tractor is 3:5:2. The speed of a jeep is speed of the jeep is 250% of the speed of the tractor, and the tractor covers 360 km in 12 hours. What is the average speed of car and jeep together? Okay, so here speed of jeep will be 250%, that is 250/100. Speed of tractor 360/12. So this is 5/2 into 30. So this is 15 into 5, that is 75 kilometer per hour, and the speed of car will be, if you take these two ratio 3 and 2, that is speed of car and speed of tractor. So this will be 3/2 into speed of tractor is 30, that is 45 kilometer per hour. Okay. Speed of the car. So the required average will be required average current Jeep, that is 45 plus 75 upon 2. This is 5 5 10, 7 4 11 and 1 12. So 120 upon 2, so this will be 60 km/h. Okay, so 60 km/h will be the average speed of car and Jeep together. Now if you look at options, A will be the right option. Okay, so this is the end of this quantitative aptitude quiz based on percentage. Now okay friends, thank you so much for listening. Best of luck for your exams.